Hello and welcome back in the kitchen. We have a very special tool for you, and I think you have two or three different of these in your drawer, but you need this one. This is a Profi Can opener. Why it is a Profi Can opener? Michael Haberstroh is here. Nice to meet you here.
Hello Sabine. You told it is a special one.
So, yes. But why? Why is it a special one?
So it's another technique. We open in a different way. Mm-hmm. And what we know is are all these. And if you look at home in your drawer, you will find maybe one or two of these. It's a very cheap one. Mm-hmm. I don't want to tell you that you are not able to open a can with that one. You are able to do that, but the way is how we do that. This is a designer one, a very, very...
Wow.
Yeah, it looks nice, huh? But It's the same way. I will show you. So first of all, please, would you come and give me one of that Maggi ravioli?
Okay.
We open this in an old-fashioned style.
Okay. It works.
First of all, we take the cheapest. Oh, This one don't work really. But now we are in. But what is the problem? You have a lever. You have to press here, turn here, and the left-hand use is not possible. And it's really, really... Oh, wow. Look at this. Look at my finger. It's really, really hard and strong. But I don't like that the lid is... You push the lid into the content of the can.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have the content, the sauce on the lid. And after that, the lid will come up again.
It's really
and the sauce
unhygienic.
is going back into the can, and it's not hygienic. I stopped it. This is too hard. So I take the designer one. This one costs around about 20 pounds, more than 30, 40 US dollar. Oh, look at that. What we're doing here. It's a metal splinter here.
Is here outside?
Yes, as well. But we have more in the can inside. So we use this one. At least it's a bit better, but it's the same. Now the lid is falling into the content.
Mm-hmm.
You have to pull it out. Anyway, what we've done, that's a lid, it's horrible sharp. And you have to know, in the United Kingdom, 50,000 people per year, they hurt themselves with these kind of sharp lids. And look at that.
Only in the United Kingdom?
Not only, there's a study, but in Germany, maybe more, or in the States, there are more people. So, but you know that. Everybody knows it. Everybody have this problem if they use these old-fashioned style can opener.
Mm-hmm.
But put it away. I don't like this. But let's have a look inside of the can. What we have, I have to be careful that I don't cut myself here. I go inside only here, and we have a look here at my finger. And you see small metal splinters, metal dust, and that's inside of the can in the content, and you eat it.
Oh,
and that's not really healthy.
Uh-huh.
I don't like it, so we do it away, huh?
Do you have another G?
The next thing. I need another one, please.
Maggi ravioli?
Yes, it's a German style, but it's now international. It's from Nestle, but we don't make advertising, so forget it. But now, we have no lever. We have only a turning wheel, a guiding rail here. This is a transportation wheel. There's a spring inside. And down here, the small wheel is not sharp. This one opens the can, but we don't cut. We press to open.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to show you that. First of all, turn back that the spring is able to pull the wheel out. Then lay it flat down on top, in front and back, and then turn forward. And that's it. And if you use this the first time, you will say, oh God, it don't work. Because it's so easy.
You can't see anything.
No, because look, now I feel it, I hear it click, and it's easy. Now turn back to release, and
what happened now?
It's not open, you think. It's open, but not on top. We open in the folded edge of the can. Where the canning factory closed the can, we open it again. Here you see behind another sheet of metal, the white one, that prevents the metal splinters from falling into the content of the can. But that's not all. There's nothing sharp. Not on the can and not on the lid. Please have a look at that. Would you be the kind and try to cut the tomato with a lid? You have no chance?
No.
You have no chance. You may press it, but not cut it. And you're able to reuse the lid again. Maybe you have dog food, cat food, and so we are able to reuse the lid and to keep something fresh for 1 or 2 days. And that's the difference. It's another technique. So we have another thing we want to do.
So we have many different kinds of cans.
So, yes, please, would you be the kind, you open with that one, and I will open with an old-fashioned style can opener. So please, would you be kind to
turn
open that? Turn it back, lay it flat down.
It's easy.
It's easy?
Really?
So, look, turn back. So it's open, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I do the same with an old-fashioned style can opener. Go in. And what happened now? Look at that. It welts out. That means that, oh, it's under pressure, but it's not really easy because it's a small tin. So what I'm doing, I'm always inside of the can. That means it's not really hygienic. Let's have a look at the can opener. And what is that? So if you put it in the dishwasher, it's rusty. And with a rusty can opener, we do not open any can.
Many people before touch this can will...
You touch it, and you have inside. So you have to pull it out, so it's inside, and it's not really hygienic. I don't like that. So you open the first side.
Yes.
Let's have a look if it's open.
I think so.
It's open.
Yes.
But now I want to show you a trick. So
it's closed.
We close it again. We turn it. And we open the second side. And always, if you want to have the content in one piece, you open both sides.
Mm-hmm.
Turn back. And now we've opened the first side.
Mm-hmm.
We open the second side. And let's have a look now. It's a bit easier to bring it out.
Mm-hmm.
It's a bit warm here in the studio. The light and everything. It's a little bit warm, but it's like a cook. That way. So.
Professional.
Don't use this, we use our Profi Can opener, but we have sometimes very, very difficult to open.
Okay, here's a
thanks,
nail killer.
Thanks, yes, you know that always. The industry, they use it because they know that the people have no chance to open these cans with an old-fashioned style can opener, so they have this one. But if you use
should
it...
Should I try?
No, please don't try that. Don't try that. We... Just have a look at this. I wanna, you wanna try that with the fingernails? Don't cut your fingernails. Don't break it. But if you do that, I will help you. Come on. And now, if you, you have the sauce everywhere, and it's dangerous because just stop, please. This is so sharp. Stop. This is so sharp, like a knife. And I wanna take the tomato to show you how sharp this is.
Wow.
This is fantastic sharp. You will cut everything with it. And if you will, if you finish your job here now, it's like a spring. And you would spray everything in the kitchen, it looks like Van Gogh.
Oh.
Was there. But now, just have a look here. I open this can always in the same way. Turn back and then forward. And this is not really interesting. Let it there. Don't pull it away. We are, we turn over and look at that. And if we are able to open this kind of a can, of a tin, without spraying the sauce around, so I will tell you, it's a perfect way to open any kind of a tin.
Mm-hmm.
Turn back, and look at that, it's open, but we have no sharp edges, not on the tin, nor on the tin, either on the lid, and you are able to reuse the lid again, and that's the perfect way to open tins.
Great, very great.
So, the next thing you all know that, we did it before, open the first side, open the second side. For example, corner beef or something like this. It's so easy in the use. So even a child with 9 years is able to open any kind of tin. My son is 9 years old, he's able to open any kind of a tin, doesn't matter. So would you be the kind and open a dog food, for example?
For children, with sharp edges.
Yeah, and now, what do you think? Is it easy or not? You feel
very
a pressure?
Easy.
It's very easy.
Yes.
I think you need the half pressure, the half power to open a tin with our Profi Can opener than with another, with an old-fashioned style.
It's perfect for old people.
For old people. Many people, they have problems with arthrose or something with a bones. I don't know the word in English, but many people have not the chance to open it. And so this is the perfect solution for everybody to open any kind of style, of if it's even a round, rectangle. And
you
I'm gonna
close it again.
And I want to tell you now, a hard thing to open is, may I have the ravioli, the other one, please? And if you want to open a dented can, maybe you bought it.
It's
you didn't
normally.
See it. softball. A little bit hard, but we'll try it. Huh?
Mm-hmm.
Look at that. You will never have a chance to open this with an old-fashioned style can opener because you have so deep dented cans. You may buy it in the supermarket, sometimes 50% less.
Yes.
And first of all, I have to find a place where I come in. So first turn back and then
mm-hmm.
forward. Now we are inside of the can.
Mm-hmm.
And look at that. A bit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And now the last. And look at that. Even a dented can is no problem, but we have no sharp edges, no metal splinters, nothing inside. And we are never in contact with the content. That means it's always
mm-hmm.
hygienic,
so
clean.
It's always clean.
Always clean, hygienic, clean. And that's a different, it's another technique. And that's the way we use in Germany our can opener.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe it's the way that you use it at home as well.
The perfect way, I think.